Hi everyone, welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Jasmine and I have here with me Nikhil Sharma from OLX Autos. Hi Nikhil, thanks for joining us.
Hi Jasmine, thank you for having me.
Tell us about OLX Autos.
At OLX Autos, we offer a one-stop solution to buy and sell used vehicles, from having an online evaluation of your car to have a home inspection. We offer anything and everything.
Okay, and do you have global presence?
Yes, we do. As of now, we are operational in 11 countries, including India, Indonesia, South America, and Turkey.
And what are the challenges of going global?
So there have been countless challenges. Few of the challenges we've solved is by building an internal development platform tool, because primarily one of the challenges was to reduce our time to market and accelerate our deployment velocity.
Okay. And so if I, as a user, have to create the platform, what's there under the hood of this architecture?
Okay, so as an end user, if you want to have an environment, you just go to the Orion portal and you'll just go with the... And then once you open up the Orion portal, then the DNS resolution goes to the Amazon R53. We are using it for a DNS resolution. And then it resolves the DNS to the Amazon application load balancer. And then the Amazon load application load balancer is going to send the request to our Kubernetes pods. We are using Amazon EKS as a Kubernetes, as a container orchestrator. And then all of our workload is running on AWS EKS. Here. So when you're creating a request to a new environment, you will mention some details like name of the environment, the business use case of the environment, and the business vertical that you want to create for which this environment is needed. And then this request goes to our application pod that is running on Amazon EKS, and underlying it is using Spot instances.
Okay. And what percent of Spot do you use?
As of now, we are using 100% Spot instances.
Wow, that's amazing. So how about the cost optimization that you've achieved with 100%?
So the use case that we had is that we are creating the replicas of OLX Autos environments. And we had to keep the cost in check, because if we're creating too many replicas, we're obviously increasing the cost exponentially. So that's why we just finalized that we are going to go with 100% Spot for the efficient cost utilization. And we just have to figure out how we can leverage Spot to its maximum capacity.
Okay. And as you're leveraging Spot, you also need to take care of Spot termination, right? How
yes.
do you do that?
Yes. So for that, we are using AWS Node Termination Handler. So whenever Amazon is about to terminate any Spot instances, it sends us an event which AWS Termination Handler is listening to, and then it drains out that nodes. So all the workload that was running on that Spot instances gets shifted to another node. So we do not experience any disruption in the business.
Got it. So basically the request comes to the pods which are deployed on Spot, right? And this is orchestrated by Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service.
Exactly.
Okay. And how does Amazon EKS help you?
It helps us by offloading the operational overhead, and it is helping us by handling the immense load that we are putting on it. We started with 100 pods and now we are running with 10,000 plus pods. So we are incrementally stress testing Amazon EKS. So
wow. And that's quite a journey, right? Starting from 100 pods to 10,000 pods. So
yes.
That's amazing. And how about this Amazon SNS and SKS? What is the role of these two?
Okay, so when a user is trying making a request to create an environment, ultimately what it's requesting is, I need a bunch of microservices for that business vertical. For example, if we are creating an environment for business vertical X, it may need 70 plus microservices. So this our main application. Running as a pod, it is going to create the number of jobs, Kubernetes jobs, for each microservice. For example, if you're launching three microservices, then it will create a job that will take care of launching microservice 1, launching microservice 2, launching microservice 3. Now, as we are running everything on Spot, there's a strong likelihood that before the time this job gets completed, Spot instances terminates the underlying node, and this job gets disrupted. EKS takes care of replacing this job by another job, but ultimately the process was not able to finish up the task that it was assigned to. So what we are doing is, whenever a job gets triggered to create the microservice, it sends an event to Amazon SNS.
Okay.
And then Amazon SNS fans out that message to SQS. So the new job that is getting replaced by this one watches out the AWS SQS and notices, okay, there's an unfinished job, and that job was supposed to launch microservice 1, but it failed to do so due to XYZ reason. So that takes care of launching and finishing the job.
Okay, great. So you have different jobs spinning up different microservices,
yes.
right? Every job stores the state in through SNS to SKS.
Yes.
And when the job comes up, the new job comes up, it also checks SQS if there is anything pending to be processed.
Exactly. So it watches out SQS so that we are having consistent state of the provisioning and maintenance of environments.
Okay. And what's the benefit of this architecture?
So with this architecture, we are able to increase our deployment velocity and our global expansion. In December 2021, we are operating in 9 markets. Now we are operating in 11 markets, touch wood.
Okay.
And it also helped in reducing our time to market, shipping up our features faster to production.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Nikhil, for sharing this architecture.
It's a pleasure, Jasmine.
And thank you, everyone, for joining us for This Is My Architecture.